Asianet News brings you Youth Express, a program that tells you what the young are thinking in Kerala and outside. Today we discuss young in law. There was a time when the judiciary and lawyers were held in very high esteem. Most of our freedom fighters were lawyers, Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, and many others. And the young respected them. Do the young still respect our judiciary? Do the young still want to be lawyers? These are issues which we would be discussing today. And to discuss them, we have a panel of three young people today, starting with Kenny. Kenny, have you ever thought of being a lawyer?
Not earlier, but right now, yes.
Yes, that's because you're on the show.
Not becoming a lawyer, but learning law.
You're an entrepreneur.
Yes.
What is your basic qualification?
I'm a computer science engineer.
Yeah, but you never thought ever of becoming a lawyer before?
No.
Deepthi. Have you ever come across any lawyers, any judges whom you hold in respect?
Yeah, actually, I have an uncle in my family itself, so he's a lawyer. He's not here in India right now, but then he's abroad. But then, yeah.
I'm asking you the same question. Did you ever want to become a lawyer?
Not really. I've never thought of that in that sense. So, not really.
And then we have Krishna. I'm sure you wanted to be a lawyer all along, isn't it?
Yes.
It shows on your face.
Yes.
Why did you want to be a lawyer?
So there are several reasons. First of all, my father is a lawyer. So I have seen what exactly happens in a court. The whole process of litigation, it has caught my attention from the young age itself. To be part of a process at the end of which a person is offered a ray of hope or justice, to be precise, that is what exactly brought me into this profession. And I'm studying law right at this moment.
And naturally, as an expert, we have as our guest, Sangeeta Lakshmanan. Sangeeta, you are a very senior advocate in the High Court of Kerala, aren't you?
Somewhere between a junior and a senior, call me so.
What makes a senior advocate? A junior advocate?
Senior in the sense you need a lot of experience in terms of the years that you put in, probably. Yes, and then the expertise that you require to call yourself.
You're part of this broad system of administering justice.
Yes.
Can I ask you, what is justice?
Justice is objective. See, for me, if you ask me what justice is all about, I would say that it is something that has to, that I get what I deserve, what I am entitled to, both. There's a difference between getting what you deserve and what you're entitled to.
Does the concept of justice change from time to time? What was just 100 years ago? Is it just now? Or is it considered unjust and vice versa? What do you say, Krishna?
Yes, sir. The whole concept of justice, it changes with time. Because with the change in the society, the concept of justice, it changes with individual perception. But anyway, injustice or injustice in the bigger sense, it is always injustice.
Long ago, Morarji Desai, he said that justice should not only be done, but should be seen to be done. Is the opposite happening these days? Is justice today just being seen to be done, but not being done?
I have my differences there. I don't think that it is just being seen to be done. It is being done. There is a whole system of what we call the justice delivery system through courts.
Is that delivering justice?
Definitely, yes.
Kenny, would you agree? Is our justice system, they've got a huge machinery for it. Is it delivering justice the way young people would like it?
To an extent, yes.
And that justice is happening all across the country. Would you agree, Deep?
Not really. See, I'm not blaming the judicial system or anything, but then the lag and the delay that's coming. You know, there are so many lakhs and lakhs of pending cases in the courts. Why is that happening? So see, when that is there, our confidence in the judicial system is going down. For a common man, his final hope is the judicial system.
Is that so?
Yeah.
Because today, there are people who believe that there is one system of justice for the rich, and one system of justice for the poor.
Yeah. See, what I'm trying to say is that, see, sometimes, you know, even when a common man, he's going over there, he has a case or something, but then when he's standing against an affluent person, won't he have an apprehension that whether I'll win the case? He will obviously have.
So rich.
Yeah, the rich
there's
and
a
the
justice
affluent.
A system of justice for the rich and one for the poor?
See, it's not basically the judicial system that has to be blamed.
No, I'm not.
We're not blaming the judicial system. But then still.
You are to blame. I'm to blame. We are all to blame.
That is it. See, the thing is that, you know, when you're going over there with your evidences, are the evidences correct? That's the first thing we have to check.
She has no first-hand information about what is happening in the courts, probably. She's not a litigant herself. She's never been a litigant herself. She does not know what is the kind of dispensation of justice that's been done through the courts.
It would be 90% of the young people there are like her.
Radical error is that you think the justice is available only for the influential, for the rich. Is that what you think?
No, that is also happening, right? That is also
probably because they can afford senior, expensive lawyers.
If I am a common man.
You think no one from the downtrodden is getting justice?
No, I'm not telling that at all.
No,
suppose if I am a common man, okay, fine. I'm going and filing my case. See how much money I have to spend. Maybe if I don't have the money, what do I do?
The High Court, if you want to stand up and ask for an adjournment, would require.
There is something called the Legal Services Authority that has been initiated by the Supreme Court and now being monitored through the High Courts as well as the trial courts as well.
That doesn't happen with everyone.
And now, unlike old times, there are competent lawyers prepared to work along with the Legal Services Authority, wholeheartedly willing to offer free legal assistance to the poor who are genuinely needy.
Whole process of litigation, the end product is always justice. There is no difference between a poor and a rich man in front of the court. Maybe a rich man may be able to afford a better lawyer, but at the same time, free legal service has been imprinted into our constitution, into our law. If a person can't afford a lawyer, the courts will arrange a lawyer for him.
That's right.
I'm going to ask you a very personal question. You don't have to answer it if you don't want to. I understand, Sankita Lakshmanan. Your father was
Inspector General of Police.
Inspector General of Police. Lakshmanan,
when he retired, who was
allegedly involved in the murder shootout of the Naxalite Varghese. He is in jail today. Isn't that right?
True, very true.
Okay, do you think justice has
been
done?
Sadly true.
Do you think justice has been done in this case?
We are waiting. When you get entangled in a litigation, be it in the way of a conviction or maybe that you're charged of a criminal offence that is offence against you, you wait for the process, entire process, legal process to complete. Forget about my biological connection with my father, with Mr. Lakshmanan.
Yeah.
I think 2.5 for a life convict to wait until he gets justice from the apex court is not that big a deal.
But if he is not responsible, if this was a miscarriage of justice, he has lost 2.5 years in jail, isn't it?
I have umpteen clients whom I have brought out of various central prisons in Kerala.
But your life is gone.
Let me tell you. There is this boy, for example, young boy who got into the prison. He was taken and convicted and sent over to the prison when he was 21 years old. He spent 7 years there. It is after 7 years that the High Court had taken up the matter.
If you had to spend 7 years in jail for a crime you did not commit, what would you say to that?
Please listen to this. Seventh year he comes out.
Right.
Acquitted by the High Court.
Right. So after 7 years you're acquitted. You spent 7 years in jail. You're 28 years old. Your life is gone.
So
what would you say to that?
No smoke without a fire. There may be some reason why I'm spending time in jail.
Not always. Because we do not have a police force that takes pride in its integrity.
Does he not have. Does he get a compensation?
No.
Why is that? Not under Indian law.
For his 7 years lost.
We wait for such legislations to come. Let us wait.
Somebody has made a mistake.
Judges are allowed to make mistakes.
Not compensation from the judiciary, but compensation from the government.
I would love the idea of a trial court or maybe a high court judge getting, having been made personally accountable for the error that he committed. No, like in this case, 7 years later, the High Court Division Bench acquits this person. 7 years, seven prime years of his life he spends along with convicts.
Absolutely. He'll come back a hardened criminal.
He spends and comes out to the society. He goes there totally innocent as a nice man only because he was implicated or maybe, as I said, we do not have a police force that takes pride in its integrity.